Hello, my name is Kate and I work at Winchester Cathedral as the choirs officer, and I'm going to be talking in today's musical moment about one of my favourite instruments, the oboe. Now, I have been playing the oboe for many, many years and I think it's one of the best instruments in the orchestra, but I am a little bit biased. Now, you might not think you've ever heard of an oboe before, but I bet you may have heard it being played. We quite often get confused for clarinets, because they do look similar with the wooden body and the silver metal keywork, but there's one key difference with an oboe that a clarinet does not have, and that is a double reed. Now, the clarinet does have a reed, but this is a special one on the oboe because it is two reeds together that make the noise. So you can see here that the reed has three main sections to it. It has this cork section at the bottom. This is so that we're able to place it in the oboe at the top. Then it has this string, which is wound tightly around, and then a metal bit at the top here. And what it is tightly wound around is these two bits of wood, which you can see there. And what happens is when you blow down it, the air goes down and it makes the vibrations through the oboe, which then enables it to make a sound. Now, we don't have a mouthpiece like a brass instrument, so this is our kind of alternative for that. Now, you can make a noise out of just playing down the reed. It's quite an interesting noise and it sounds a little bit like a bird or a duck. And this is what it sounds like if you just play the reed. So it does sound a little bit like the birds in the morning. And these reeds are very precious because they're made so particularly in this certain way with the two bits of wood bound together that oboes tend to be very protective over their reeds. And actually, some oboists make their own reeds, but it is a very specialist skill and it is a very time consuming skill. So I just buy them off the internet for my oboe. Now, as you can see, I've popped a reed in the top of the oboe here. And when we blow down it with the reed in, we get a noise that is more common to the oboe rather than the squeaky noise, which sounds like this. Quite a pretty sound, the oboe, and it's quite often used in music to portray beauty and often angelic sounds. Now, we are very important in the orchestra because we tune the whole orchestra. So if you go to a concert where you see an orchestra and all the players come in, they sit down and then you'll hear the oboe play a concert A, which sounds like this. Now, the oboist would have checked before they come on the stage that A is in tune. And then you'll see all the other players start to ensure that their instrument is in tune with that A. So it's very important that we are there. We are a wind instrument that very rarely goes out of tune. And also we can be heard a lot of the time. It's very piercing through the noise, a bit like a piccolo, but less high. Now, in the orchestra, we sit in a really great place. We're right in the middle. We tend to be just behind the strings and then just in front of the brass and the percussion. It can vary with different orchestras, but our neighbours tend to be the flautists and the clarinetists and the bassoonists. So we are in a really great place and you often get a really good view of the conductor, which is good to know that you're playing in time. Now, you're probably thinking, Kate, I've never heard the oboe before in anything other than an orchestra. So here's some music that you may recognize that has the oboe in. The first one is from the ballet Swan Lake. Now, you may recognize this as it's a really famous piece of music, even if you've never seen the ballet. And the oboe has this beautiful, beautiful solo. So I'm going to show you a clip of that now. Thank you. every time I hear that, I just think of the beauty of the swans and how much the oboe contributes to creating that atmosphere. The second piece you might not recognise, but maybe an adult who lives with you might. Now, this is a piece of music that is used for the Office theme tune, the TV show The Office. And a fun fact about this one is the gentleman that played the oboe solo is actually a saxophonist, and his wife was an oboist. So she taught him how to play it so that he could take the job and pay for his whole wedding. So this is the Office theme tune. Goodbye. And finally, a piece of music that you may recognise is... You may recognize some pieces where you've heard the oboe, because we're not very well represented in media. We tend to see lots of violins and trumpets and timpani and things like that, and that's absolutely fine, but we are definitely important. So our range is quite small for a wind instrument. The flutes can play very high and clarinets can tend to play very low. The oboe is kind of in the middle. Our lowest note tends to be this B flat here. And our highest note can vary based on which oboe you have, but today is this note. It's very rare that we would play that note, but there are lots of pieces where it is used, so it is important that we are able to use them. Now, we play by blowing down the reed, and then the music comes out the bottom, or the sound comes out the bottom here, which is the bell, which is a rounded sound. Now, this is similar to our ancestor. So the oboe comes from the shawm, which was a Renaissance instrument. The oboe actually came into the orchestra around the 18th century, but was known to be used in French music in the 17th century. So as well as being part of the woodwind family, the oboe has a family of its own. We also, alongside the oboe, have the cor anglais, which is a larger oboe, and then oboe d'amore, which means oboe of love. So I'm going to finish by playing you some of my favourite oboe pieces. I've just got three pieces that I'd love to play for you. The first piece of music is a piece of music written by Mozart, who you may have heard of. Now, this is a very prominent piece in the oboe canon of music, and it's got lots of fast, intricate bits. Now, I'm only going to play the little portion of the first movement for you today. I mentioned that the oboe is quite often used to show angelic things, and that is very true in music. So I'm now going to play Gabriel's oboe, which comes from the film The Mission, and this is a very, very well-known piece of music. Thank you. So finally, I'm going to play a piece of music that you might have heard of if you haven't heard of The Others. Now, this comes from the film Hercules, and it is I Won't Say I'm in Love, which is sung by Meg. Enjoyed learning about the oboe today, and join us next week for next week's musical moment. If you are being encouraged to keep a jar of positivity, maybe you could put something that you learnt from this video in there. Please stay safe and have a musical day, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.